Hi there, and welcome back to 365 Data Science. In today's lesson, we'll explore the crucial topic of data modeling. Throughout this lesson, we'll cover what data modeling is and its fundamental concepts, why it matters in modern data architecture, key components of data models, real-world applications and use cases, and the impact of data modeling on business success. Well, let's dive in and discover how data modeling shapes the foundation of effective data systems. When a building is being constructed, long before the first bricks are put down or any kind of groundwork begins, architects draw several blueprints with the building's design, including measurements of every inch of raw material that needs to go in construction. What do you think will happen if the construction crew started constructing an 80-story building without an architect's blueprints? Well, thankfully, we don't have to live in that world. Data model is a theoretical design of how data will be structured, stored, and used within a system. It's the process of visually representing the relationships between different data elements, their attributes, and the rules governing their interactions. In short, data modeling translates real-world scenarios into a structured format that databases and systems can understand before the development begins. For example, imagine a simple e-commerce store. The store has some key components like customers, books, and orders. Data modeling will help define how these individual data sources will be stored and also explain the relationship between these components. For instance, a customer will place an order that will consist of one or more products. Let's look at how a basic data model is represented. It shows customers, orders, and products as entities and how they interact. This diagram is called an entity relationship diagram, referred to as an ERD. But before we get into ERDs, a quick word about today's lesson. If you're finding this introduction to data architecture helpful, you'll love our comprehensive courses at 365datascience.com. We offer in-depth training at data architecture, data engineering, and building data pipelines from scratch. Our step-by-step approach helps you master these crucial skills at your own pace, with hands-on projects and real-world examples. Now, let's return to our exploration of architecture types. We've seen a rough draft of a simple data model, and you hopefully now have an idea of what a data model is and what purpose it's supposed to serve. But why is data modeling important? If you really were building a house without a blueprint, can you imagine what might go wrong? You might end up with a beautiful kitchen, except the plumbing does not get water. Or the drain does not go into the main sewer. Or maybe you build a stunning living room, only to realize that the electric wiring is not connected to the main line. Without a plan, you're likely to waste time and resources fixing problems later. The same principle applies to data. Without a clear model, you risk building systems that are inefficient, inconsistent, and hard to maintain. So data modeling is critical because 1. A data model improves communication between different stakeholders like developers, analytics, and business leaders by acting as a common language between them. Everyone can see and agree on how the data should be structured and how it should function. 2. With a model in place, you can set rules for your data, ensuring accuracy and consistency, and therefore improving overall data quality. 3. A good data modeling exercise also potentially saves cost and time because catching and fixing issues during the modeling phase is much cheaper than fixing them after the system is built. 4. And finally, a well-designed data model makes it easier to adapt and grow your system as business needs evolve, making your architecture scalable. Now that we understand what the data model is and why it's important, let's talk about some common use cases for data modeling. When would a data modeling exercise be most beneficial? When you're building a new database, whether you're creating a relational database or a NoSQL database, Data modeling can help define the structure for a new database. If you're trying to combine data from multiple systems coming in different data formats, a data model helps you map relationships between the different data sources to ensure consistency and easy handling. When designing a data warehouse, building a robust model can apply proper constraints and indexes to optimize the data for advanced analysis. And lastly, data models provide a thorough roadmap for developers to know how data will flow through the application, helping them in application development. Data modeling has become a core exercise in building data architectures today. But do you know the concept of data modeling was first introduced in the 1970s? The entity relationship model, created by Peter Chen over 40 years back, is still widely used today. It just goes to show how fundamental data modeling is in the data world. Data modeling is one of the first steps in building a robust data architecture. It ensures your data is organized and accessible, laying the groundwork for data governance, security, quality management, and beyond. Without a strong model, your data architecture could crumble under the weight of bad design decisions. Think of data modeling as the foundation of a pyramid. Everything else in your data architecture, governance, quality, analytics, and more rests on this solid base. Now let's recap the key points we've covered in this lesson. Data modeling is the process of creating a theoretical design for data structure and relationships. It serves as a blueprint before actual database implementation. Data modeling improves communication between stakeholders. It ensures data quality and consistency. And finally, it saves time and resources by preventing future structural issues. Well, thanks for joining us in this video on data modeling. If you found this information valuable, check out our complete data architecture course at 365datascience.com for more in-depth content on building robust data systems. And until next time, keep learning!